Ooh. I can only record 19 minutes. I gotta go delete some videos. But anyways, yeah, we are Antifa's not trying to kill 30 people or shoot 30 people, kill 6. Sniping them from a roof. Nah. It's not what Antifa's about. I'm not saying we, you know what I'm saying, Antifa can't do some destruction and shit, but I think their focus is more of the Proud Boys and Trump and shit like that. Like, innocent bystanders. That's a MAGA thing. There's probably gonna be more of them, especially once the news comes out. You know what I'm saying? They lock Trump's ass up. These motherfuckers gonna lose their goddamn minds. They already threatening it. That if Trump gets locked up, they gonna do some shit. So, we'll see.
I don't know if my game started up yet or not. But... Nope. I don't even really want to play this shit.
Bitch is taking forever. Play it. I'm not gonna go to bed, dude. I'm gonna turn the TV on. Turn on CNN.
Doesn't give the EPA broad authority to regulate greenhouse gas emissions from power plants. The five-year drilling plan doesn't rule out new offshore drilling. It proposes options ranging from no new drilling to 10 lease sales in the Gulf of Mexico and one proposed sale in waters off Alaska. The last remaining Medal of Honor recipient from World War War II will be given the honor of lying in state at the U.S. Capitol. Herschel Woodrow Williams, a hero of the Battle of Iwo Jima, passed away at the age of 98 Wednesday. President Harry Truman awarded the Medal of Honor to Williams at the White House back in 1945. Affectionately known as Woody, the West Virginia native had already been chosen to lie in state at the state capitol in Charleston. Williams' remarkable service to his country didn't end with the war. He continued to serve the VA for 33 years. The exact timing of Williams being honored in the nation's capital will be announced at a later date. Pope Francis isn't letting his health issues get in the way of his duties at the Vatican. He's currently recovering from a small fracture in his knee, and one of his ligaments was inflamed. The Pope is denying rumors that he had cancer and has no plans of stepping down anytime soon. Francis was scheduled to visit two African countries this month, but doctors advised him to skip the trips because of his knee problems. He does plan to make visits to Ukraine and Russia.
Well, my grandparents just live right up the street, so the whole family always met there.
A tradition that brings in people from around the state. We head out to the Faith 4th of July. Plus, we check in on other Independence Day celebrations across the Tar Heel State.
None but a bunch of fucking racists. Well, there was a bunch of black people and Hispanics and shit out there, but there was a lot of racist black people.
Street in downtown Harrisburg. Record showed it had been built in the 1930s, around the same time builders used animal hair plaster like the kind found with Wesley Person's body.
We're hoping for slugs, or we're hoping for bullet holes in their walls, we're hoping for anything we can get. We were unsuccessful.
Investigators sprayed luminol in the basement of Lawrence Morrell's construction property on South 13th Street and ran into an unexpected problem. And as we're looking at that, Crime Lab Techs are explaining to me that in Harrisburg, the soil is iron rich. The iron in itself would be a false positive so on the luminol test. But in the basement, investigators found a pile of debris swept into a corner. They gathered everything and sent it to the forensic lab. Under a microscope, scientists found pieces of drywall with the same blue and pink paint layers as the drywall found underneath Wesley's body.
What are the odds that you and I both went to Home Depot and bought the same paints all the time and painted our walls the same colors year after year after year?
But were both samples the same paint? Analysts put both samples under a scanning electron microscope.
You're using the microscope and all of the features of the microscope to be able to see what's included in that chemical composition of the paint.
The chemical structures in both samples were identical. Scientists also found animal hair plaster. But this wasn't just any animal hair. The animal hair in the plaster found underneath Wesley's body had something in common with the animal hair in the plaster from the renovated house.
I was able to say that these were animal hairs that were from the same animal. They knew that they had the right residents. They knew that they had the right people.
But the ultimate proof came from a piece of ductwork from the basement floor. Testing showed it contained a tiny speck of human blood. And DNA testing left no doubt who the blood had come from.
And it being the blood of West Coast, we had found our crime scene. We had the victim's blood there.
Investigators felt they knew who planned this attack.
Justin Glover's an idiot. Lawrence Morrell is the smart one here, and he's the one with the brains to be able to put this thing together.
But could they place Justin Glover and Lawrence Morrell at the scene?
She's feeling the power of Listerine. He's feeling it. Yep, them too. It's an invigorating rush, sapping millions of germs in seconds. For that one-of-a-kind whoa, which leaves you feeling... Listerine. Feel the whoa.
Audible brought real listeners together to ask, What do you love about listening?
Audible makes it very easy to listen. I want to learn about something specific. I just pull it up.
It helps me understand people more.
Music or bio or science, anything like that. Like, everything has a story.
Only Audible has audio entertainment for everyone, no matter what you're into.
The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas.
Jane Goodall. The Book of Hope.
Outliers by Malcolm Gladwell.
Text LISTEN 45 to 500-500 for 30 days free.
As a trans man, it's really beautiful to be able to hear yourself in stories.
That view into what's going on, especially when it's people who don't look like us.
It just paints more of a world for you, you know? Like, the story's more vivid in a way.
Exactly. It's always an adventure. It's always something to jump into.
And then you realize that after you kind of listen to some of these stories, like, this perspective that I maybe didn't know before, that in itself is transformational.
Only Audible has audio entertainment for everyone, all in one place. Text LISTEN 45 to 500-500 for 30 days free.
Now you can get your favorite jersey faster than ever at Fanatics.com. Introducing Fanatics MVP. With next business day shipping, official jerseys from all the leagues and teams you love. Fanatics.com. Officially licensed everything.
Poshmark is the perfect side hustle. There's so much I can sell. Bags, clothes, and even electronics. It's so easy. I can list in 60 seconds or less. I can't imagine a better side hustle.
For back pain, I've always been a take two and call in the morning guy. But my new doctor recommended Salonpas. Without another pill upsetting my stomach, I get powerful, effective, and safe relief. Salonpas, it's good medicine.
Diamonds, still at bargain prices. Half carat solitaires are $4.99. 1 carat, $9.90. 2 carat, $12.50 per carat. Plus 1 carat studs, $5.99. And the guaranteed lowest prices on thousands of GIA diamonds. Buy direct at the Jewelry Exchange.
I'm here at home with Officers Martinez and Endicott. They're here because my SimpliSafe security camera captured an uninvited guest. SimpliSafe monitoring pros used the video to have a little chat with police, telling what was going down. The officers tell me that video verification helps them get there lightning fast. It's all part of SimpliSafe's comprehensive 24/7 whole home security.
Right now, get 20% off plus a free indoor camera when you sign up for interactive monitoring. Only from SimpliSafe.
My moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. Tightness, stinging, pain.
Emerge Tremfya. With Tremfya, most people saw 90% clear skin at 16 weeks. The majority of people saw 90% clear skin even at 5 years.
Serious allergic reactions may occur. Tremfya may increase your risk of infections and lower your ability to fight them. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, or if you had a vaccine or plan to.
Emerge Tremfya. With Tremfya. Ask your doctor about Tremfya today.
I feel so good. Quilted Marlin Ultra Soft and Strong is made using an energy efficient process. Three trees are also planted for each one used. Quilted Marlin, premium comfort made sustainable.
No. No. Get down. Get down. Get down. Get down. Come on, get in.
Both Lawrence Morrell and Justin Glover denied any involvement in Wesley Person's murder. They both claimed they had alibis for that night.
13 minutes.
So investigators checked the man's cell phone records.
Glover's phone is trackable with because he is...
Y'all gonna see more of these pointless videos.
...receiving calls, he's making calls. And from those cell phone calls, we're able to see what tower, the closest tower that that cell phone was going to hit off of.
Glover said he was with his girlfriend.
He made a series of telephone calls to his girlfriend from his cellular telephone, which was not consistent with being with her the whole night.
The cell phone records show that Glover was in the area where the burning body was later found.
And a check of Lawrence Morrell's cell phone record showed he was in the area as well.
At 4:30 in the morning, his cell phone is used right near the Capitol building.
Morrell was checking his voicemail. Oddly, so was someone else. At the exact same place and exact same time.
It shows when you look at the cell phone records that they were together.
Harrisburg, Pennsylvania is about 65 miles from where Wesley Person's body was set on fire in Maryland.
10 weeks after Wesley Person was killed, Justin Glover and Lawrence Morrell were arrested and charged with his murder. Prosecutors believe Wesley Person cashed a check for a fraudulent bank loan without telling his partners. And in doing so, signed his own death warrant.
Justin Glover, Lawrence Morrell, were supposed to receive at least $1,000 each from each of these loans.
Prosecutors believe Glover and Morrell found out and wanted revenge. They picked him up in Harrisburg, then took him home so he could get the money they believe he'd stolen from them. Then they forced Wesley back into their car and drove him to the home on South 13th Street in Harrisburg that Morrell was renovating. The evidence shows this was where they shot Person 3 times in the head. His blood spattered onto a piece of ductwork on the basement floor. The two men cleaned up the scene, but didn't see the blood on the ductwork. They wrapped the body in construction plastic, unaware that bits of animal hair plaster were wrapped with it. Plaster that tied the body to the house. After driving 65 miles to the outskirts of Baltimore, they hauled the body down an embankment, doused it with fuel, and set it on fire. But the fire didn't consume Wesley's entire body. Enough remained to create this likeness, and the animal hair plaster and construction plastic ultimately led police to the murder scene.
Is that nice pile of
animal hair plaster?
Wesley Person's case would be unsolved today.
Justin Glover and Lawrence Morrell were convicted of first-degree murder and sentenced to life in prison without parole.
First thing I think of when I think of this case is exceptional forensic investigation. Hands down, the best forensic work I've ever seen in any case I've been involved in. This is one case that probably encompasses about every genre of forensic science that's out there.
Oh, this was probably the most interesting case I've had yet.
You would think that their friendship would trump money, but it appears as if, I guess in this case, money trumped friendship in this case.
Damn, they released one of them from prison.
And no one knows why.
Maybe he had
years
to something through his work.
Despite the best of medical intensive care, he does
my shit. I like watching this shit.
Is it suicide? Is it homicide?
But investigators know there must be a clue somewhere.
Forensic files.
The more bizarre it got.
The research triangle in Raleigh-Durham, North Carolina. Home
North Carolina.
To high-tech research and development companies. 30-year-old Eric Miller worked there looking for a cure for pediatric AIDS. His wife, Ann, was also a scientist working for a large pharmaceutical company.
Eric and Ann Miller were living the American dream.